Hey, Brian Mertens here, and in this video, we're going to talk about animal tracks. Animal tracks come in all different shapes and sizes, and if you want to become skilled at reading the stories of the sand, then you need to have a strategy for how you can pull information from those impressions you see on the ground. What I'm going to share with you over the next few minutes is a blueprint for how to do this. We're going to get really familiar with what the components of a track actually are. This is one of the very first hurdles that you need to get over on your quest to becoming a tracker. And if you can learn to recognize these five components of tracks in the field, then you'll have a framework for gathering the important information and finding out who left the track. It's basic stuff, but oh so important. So come along with me and we're gonna revolutionize your tracker's eye. So here is our track, and here is your track. Now, what's the difference between these two tracks? Obviously they are different, but what if you had to explain the difference to someone who couldn't see what you're seeing? We need to have a way of quantifying the difference in order to communicate and have confidence about what it is that we're seeing. And this is why it's so important to know the individual components of a track. This is what makes it possible for us to pass on our knowledge really easily. And the take home for you is that this is the whole secret for you learning to identify animal tracks in the field. For example, take a look at the number of toes on these two tracks. If you know the number of toes that an animal has, then you can greatly narrow down the list of potential animals when you see a track. Dogs and cats have four main toes that register in their tracks. Deer and other grazing animals have two. You have five. So one of the easiest ways to effectively quantify the difference between these two tracks is that this track has five toes, and this track only has four. That's pretty simple to grasp, even if you can't see the track. So this is the first component that you always need to be looking for when you're out tracking. The next thing we want to be looking at is the nails. Looking for nails can be really helpful because some animals, like the canine family, have nails that usually register in the tracks, whereas other animals, like cats, they usually don't register in the tracks. The relative sharpness versus dullness of the nails can also be a really good indicator of domestic animals versus wild animals. Our third track component is called the metacarpal pad. The metacarpal pad is this area right here, and that's your metacarpal pad. And it's not to be confused with the heel pad, but uh-oh, where's our heel pad on our dog track? And this is where we see one of the other major differences between humans and dogs. Dogs don't really have heel pads that register in their tracks. They're missing our fourth track component, and they actually walk on their toes. So this is a good demonstration of why knowing the track topography is so important, because it gives us direct insight into the animal when we see a track impression in the sand or in the mud. Pretty cool, huh? Now, the final track component that we're going to look at is the negative space. Negative space is the gap that's created between the metacarpal pad and the toes. It's actually the absence of an impression, and different animals will produce different shapes with their negative space that enables you to tell them apart much more easily. The best way to observe the negative space is by imagine a line flowing between the metacarpal pad and the toes. Some negative space will be an X shape, some will be a star shape, and some negative space will be like a sideways C shape. And that's negative space. So there you have your complete track topography. Toes, nails, metacarpal pad, heel pad, and negative space. And now that you know to look for these components in tracks, you've just shaved years off your learning journey. All you gotta do now is get out there, put this into practice, and let me know how it goes. I also wanna invite you right now to subscribe to this channel. Click this button to subscribe, and I'll talk to you soon.